Guys, I don't know if it's because I just woke up, but like that kind of looks like CB's in 2 weeks, man. I feel like we just finished our last one. Hi, it feels like it's been a while, but welcome back to another Princess Connect video. My name is Lace, and today we're going to be talking about a whole bunch of new updates because there's quite like a few cool things that are in this one. But there are a few things that are going to make a couple of people nervous. It's made me very nervous. But generally speaking, for like the more casual or for the more normal players or whatever, for the general population that's probably like outside of top 25 clan battle clans, like this is probably like one of the better updates. We're gonna see an increase in gem income. This is gonna be the opportunity to get Makoto if you haven't got her. But yeah, I'm gonna spoil the entire video if I keep going, and so let's just jump into it with the first thing, which is the focus gacha for Matsuri. Her name is unfortunately really close to like another Japanese word, which means like, yeah, anyway. So Matsuri is a unit that is 2 stars. So this is another one of those extended 2-star banners, which is gonna last for I believe 18 days. And so you guys should recognize Matsuri. She was from the Ironclad Nightmare special event, but she also is in the Nightmare Guild. However, again, Matsuri is a 2-star, and so there has got to be a 3-star focus up, and again, that is going to be Makoto. So my guys, do not be fooled. This is not a Matsuri banner. This is a Makoto banner. And so guys, I think after all of these events back to back, like there is a serious like desire, or like there is a serious necessity of Makoto and Jun. And I think most people have realized that. And so like, if you have not picked up your Makoto, this is the time. However, I am going to put this with the caveat that we are about to go into another like limited hell. And what I mean by that is that we are about to go into this boy over here. So you can see over here, Makoto. It's not even, okay, Matsuri is over here. But after Makoto, we've got Halloween Shinobu, we've got Halloween Misaki, we've got Christina. If you are at all like remotely interested in PvP, you should be rolling for Halloween Shinobu. And then on the other hand, everybody should be rolling for Christina. And so because of like this, there are a couple of options, right? You can either, if you don't have Makoto, you could get her here, and then you could pass on the Halloween Shinobu, because like while she is really good in PvP, she's really good in PvP, but like sometimes you gotta make sacrifices, let's put it that way, right? But what I am trying to get at is that if you are going for Makoto, it's gonna be unlikely, if you are low on gems, that you're gonna be able to get Christina as well. And so the thing about Christina, again, like I've said this a million times, you can skip this Christina banner if you're a little bit more casual. It is gonna make your life a lot more hell, especially from like a CB or PvP perspective. But if you are intent on getting Makoto, you could get her here, and then you could try pick up the Christina over here. And so I've mentioned this in 50 videos now, but essentially this banner over here, this New Year's Yui, this is technically a pre-Fez banner. And so Christina is going to be in here. Like you're probably going to have to look for the spook. And that is way more worth it because these are like 5% rate ups as opposed to like a Makoto permanent banner. But yeah, that's the strat. If you don't have Makoto already, you could go for Makoto. If you are low, you skip Christina and then you get her over in Yui's New Year's. Okay, so let's get back to it over here. So we've got the Matsuri banner, which is really the Makoto banner, and I think that's it. And so next we've got the September clan battle. So this is a really interesting one, and the reason that this is really interesting because like we are starting to really deviate from a lot of different servers. And what I mean by that is that like I think the majority of you already know about this one already, but essentially we're not going to be able to get the Misato to 5-star, I believe. So in game updates, I think we should see a Misato here, this one over here. So in the upcoming clan battle, so the scorpion guy over here, the Misato 5-star is actually required for the magic comp. And if you don't have the Misato 5-star, I believe you're going to have to push your Skyaru to 5-star and your Kyoko to 4-star. And this is all running on the assumption that we're not going to be able to get Misato in time. So 245 days after JP launch, we are at 226. So this means that if we are following JP, Misato would be released in about 20 days time. However, the clan battle is going to start in 18 days time. And so what this means is that we're not actually going to be able to get Misato until potentially halfway through clan battle. And honestly, I'm not really banking on that either, because if I remember correctly, who was it? It was Ayane. She was delayed like a month or two before she actually arrived in the arena shop. And so that definitely could happen, especially with like the Misato and like all of the other characters moving forward. However, again, this is probably like only affecting like the real sweaty like tryhards like me. And on that note, I don't know if I can be the sweaty tryhard anymore, because like if this like Misato, this 5-star Misato, if she really is required, I'm pretty doomed. And the reason I'm doomed is because like I have no Illya, right? And for you guys who have been around a while, you guys should know what the mage comp looks like. And so for you guys who are not familiar, this is what the mage comp looks like, except I don't have an Illya. So what can I put there in instead. Okay, so pretend that the Yukari is the Ilya. And so again, this is the comp I'm talking about. However, sometimes you switch out the Misato for the Sciarra instead, so it looks more like this. This is kind of like your full DPS approach, again, if you think that this is the Ilya. However, in a lot of situations, this is not enough to sustain all of the damage that is coming from the boss, like depending on whether it's like boss 3 to 5 or whatever, right? Typically speaking, if you can run your mage team into the B1 or B2 and they do have like low magic defense, then you can run something like this, which is like pure offense. However, most of the time when you're running into like B5 or something, you're going to be replacing this that Kiaru with the Misato over here. Either that, or you're going to be replacing Misato with like a tank. Like sometimes it's a Shizuru, which I also don't have. Sometimes it's a Kokoro. One time it was a Tamaki. Like pretty much like essentially there is going to be a tank there instead of Misato. And so what I'm trying to say, guys, is that for this CB, if you don't have a Misato at 5 stars, then your Sciarra and your Kyoka are going to have to be 5 stars and 4 stars respectively at least. On the other hand, if you own this whole team, what you could just do is get rid of the Misato and then borrow a 5-star Misato instead. And so that's why people like me are a little bit screwed, because I've always been depending on borrowing the Ilya. However, now I need to borrow an Ilya and a 5-star Misato, which we both know is not possible. But yeah, that's kind of the impact of this one over here, but that's only the Misato shards, right? Because on the other hand, it was about this time where they started getting the Rei UE. And so the Rei UE enabled a lot of physical teams, so technically speaking, they could have been like potentially the T3. However, again, we don't have this, and so we are going to get those deviations from that one too. And lastly, I believe CN, if you go look at their spreadsheets, you're going to realize that they actually got Christina here. And so I know we've deviated from the CN bros long ago, but like we really are deviating now. And so what exactly does all of this mean to you, right? Scenario one, you've just been throwing all of your comps into CB, you've just been doing your hits, and that's kind of it. This does not affect you at all, like at all. Scenario two, you're running auto comps. Well, this probably is not going to affect you either. I highly doubt that it's going to affect you, because like if there was ever a magic auto comp, it's probably incredibly stable, especially with the inclusion of Ilya. And so again, this is probably going to only affect like the sweaty boys like me up at T25, T10, potentially T50. But not only those guys, I know like there are a lot of hardworking people like in all of the tiers, right? Just know that if you are going to use this comp, that is the caveat. That is the caveat that we know right now, because it's really hard to know what Crunchyroll or Cygames is going to do, right? They might actually tweak the defenses, stuff like that. They may bring forward phase 3, which actually is even worse. So I don't know. I don't want to talk about that one. But yeah, I think I've spent enough time on that one. I think long story short, if you didn't really get any of that, essentially we're deviating really, really hard. And if you do want a mage comp, you do need a 5-star Misato. If you have the rest of the members, Ilya, Akari, Sciarra, and Kyoka, you can borrow a 5-star Misato. However, if you're like me and you're missing any of the pieces, you're freaking donezo. And so yeah, I think that kind of wraps up like the CB aspect of this part. So yeah, with all of that being said, let's get back into the happier news. Well, I mean, it's not like that was bad news. It's just really interesting because it means that people can't copy off of the other timelines. The majority can still probably be copied, but like not all of it. All right, so again, September clan battle, we are going to be getting the Chica shard. So that's pretty sweet. But other than that, nothing left for clan battle. So let's talk about this bad boy, which is the Tower of Luna. Why is it the Tower of Luna and not Luna Tower? I guess in English, it's kind of the same thing, but like Tower of Luna, I feel like Luna Tower kind of rolls off the tongue a little bit better. Anyway, this is a pretty straightforward one. I thought I had footage of this, but I cannot find it. And unfortunately, JP is getting their Luna Tower like at the same time as us, I believe. However, I will go out and find resources for the Tower of Luna so that you guys can be a little bit prepared for it, but do not be scared of it. Like it's completely fine. So in a nutshell, I think the description is really good. So you have a dungeon with 70 floors of unique monsters and stuff. And keep in mind that there are bosses, so that might put you into crippling depressions depending on like how hard they are and how far you are in the game. But the key points are these guys over here. So your party of characters can carry over between floors, assuming none of them hit 0 HP. What this means is that sustain is a really big thing in Luna Tower. So if you go look at tier lists for like Luna Tower and stuff, you're going to see a couple of like the healers up there, and you'll have a couple more cards up your sleeve to help you survive the ascent. So yeah, that's essentially it. In our version, we're going to be climbing 70 floors. We're going to be battling a whole bunch of things, and then we're going to be trying to sustain all of it and get to the end without dying with our main team. And so the cool thing about this is that Luna Tower opens its doors for 5 days between 9:10 and 9:15, which is in 8 days time. That's really close. And so this kind of adds to like your monthly routine, where like we have CB, but then we have Tower of Luna, which is a lot more chill than CB. But not only does it add a little bit of variety to our routine, it also gives us gemmies. And generally speaking, you can expect like 1.5k gemmies from the Tower of Luna every month. So that's an extra 10 tool that you can add to your calculations if you're doing some like gem planning ahead. That's really great. However, if I can pull together a Tower of Luna video, I will do so. I know a whole bunch of you have been asking for it, and like you guys can tell me I told you so, because like I currently have ran out of time. But let's not talk about it. Come on, like bygones be bygones. Like it's the past is the past. All right, moving on. We have the game update news. That's just Area 16, Chapter 8 and Episodes 8. So I believe we are getting the Kyoka shards. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, it's really sad how I jumped like right into the Kyoka, because like nothing else matters. But the other thing I guess is that rank 11 slot 3 is being released. So there are a couple of like, how do I say it? The bricked units can be saved. Some of them, not all of them, some of them. And on the other hand, we are also getting the level cap increase to 110. So that's nice. But other than that, I think it's just like the usual stuff. We've got new furniture available. Hold up. I feel like I've seen this furniture before. I think this is actually the first furniture set that was released that I missed out on. So this is really awesome. I'm actually really ecstatic because I was really upset that I missed out on this furniture set. Like, look at that freaking Jun armor. That's not Jun standing there. That's a freaking Jun spare armor, which is really cool. But anyway, moving on. So we've got the dungeon mana times 2. Remember to rig it, guys. If you guys don't know how to rig it, I will link you guys. It's probably a Reddit post, I think, where it's going to teach you how to do it. But essentially, you want to be able to get 2x mana twice on the first day. So over here, we've got Career SMN. So big shout out to Career SMN for putting this together. And essentially, this summarizes it pretty fair, right? So 2 days before 2x dungeon starts, what you want to do is that you want to do the dungeon and beat everything up until the battle before the boss, but don't beat the boss itself. And so what this means is that on that day, you're going to be on floor 4 or floor 9, depending on which dungeon you're doing. Remember to do the hardest dungeon that you can if you can get up to the floor before the boss. And so again, you are on floor 4 or floor 9. And on top of that, you are on 0 attempts. So 0 out of 1 attempts. Now the next day rolls over. You are going to then beat the boss from the previous day and then start a new attempt. So that means that you go into the dungeon again, but you don't fight anything. And so what this does is it lets you clear the dungeon daily without giving up anything. Because what's going to happen after that is that when we roll over into the 0 day, so we are going to be in the 2x dungeon mana event, what you're going to do is that you're going to clear out the entire dungeon and then you're going to reset and then you're going to clear it out again. So what this means is that you've got another extra full dungeon's worth of 2x mana. To be honest, I've been playing far enough into the game that I don't really need to do this. However, if you guys do forget to do this step, it's not the end of the world. Like my opinion would be like on the day before. Okay, let's do it this way, right? The less optimal but more likely way that you're going to remember this is that the day before, just do 1 dungeon attempt. That's it. Just beat floor 1 and then leave all of the other floors for tomorrow when 2x dungeon mana starts. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the dungeon drop. So hopefully that's like just a quick reminder of how to do that one. And then aside from that, we've got the 2x grotto drops, which is not too much. And then we've got the normal quest drops times 2. Man, I cannot get enough of the normal quest drops. But yeah, otherwise that was pretty jam-packed. What I'm not seeing is an event. Wait a second. Hold up. Okay, guys, so this is what I'm looking at. So we've got the Ironclad Nightmare event, and then we've got the Halloween Pudding event after that. And so this is kind of what I was expecting to come, because you see over here, JP 831. And so therefore it ends on the 18th of September. And so the difference between the ending date here, so 18th of September, and this one, the starting date, the 30th of September, there's only 12 days in between like the end of the last event and the start of the next event. And so guys, that's why I'm kind of surprised that we're not getting a Halloween event here, because like this covers off a lot of September. So if our event is just about to finish, like we should expect it in 12 days time. However, I don't think we're going to be getting it in 12 days time, because we have a whole bunch of other things going on that have been announced that are over 12 days time, but then the Halloween event itself is not. Oh, okay. It's probably because they're saving it for Halloween. I can't believe it took me that long to figure out. Oh my God. You guys can tell that I'm pretty freaking fried. Okay. I mean, like that kind of makes sense. I guess we'll roll with it. Okay. I don't think it's going to change too much. It might stifle our gem income by a little bit, but like honestly, not too much. But yeah, I think we've gone through everything. Let's quickly summarize. It's looking pretty good. It's looking really spicy. If there's any time to reroll, now is the time. Like Makoto is right here. And if you don't have Makoto, consider it. However, if your gem bank is running low, I probably would say save for Christina. Moving on, remember that you're going to need a 5-star Misato if you guys are tryharding for the mage comp. After that, we've got a new game mode coming called Tower of Luna, in which we'll be getting an extra income of gemmies 1.5k per month. And then we've just got the usual updates with the game updates. We've got the new Kyoka shards coming in. And yeah, I think that pretty much summarizes it. And so you guys already know what time it is. And I know you guys don't want this time to come, but it is that time. But it's time to wrap up the video. And so secret message. And so the secret message of this video is going to be Krabby, because that's the first thing that caught my eye. And look at those pincers. Holy crap. Look, it's even sparkling. Actually, I think that sparkle is part of the effect of the back background and not the crab itself, but let's pretend that that sparkle is for those claws. And so if you guys could drop the secret message Krabby down in the comments below, I would really appreciate it, because like it means that you've made it up until the end of the video. And so thank you guys so much. But otherwise, please consider a like, a sub, a comment. You already know what it is. And if you would like to support the channel, there are a couple of different ways in the description below. We've got a membership thing. But as wise young Matsuri once said, all good things must come to an end. And so thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.